Do you want to know where I love to hunt my designer bargains? Hi and very welcome. My name is Mary. This is my channel Lumi Level Up, and I'm a luxury lover on an average income trying to be more mindful with my money. I mentioned several times before on my channel how much I love to go outlet shopping. And I have already showed you around at two outlets, the Serravalle Outlet Center in Italy and the Foxtown Factory Outlet Stores in Switzerland. Of course, I will link both of these videos for you down in the description box and at the end of this one. So if you get into an outlet shopping vlog mood, you can just binge watch them. I have told you before that I do visit the Foxtown Outlet at least once a year when we are on vacation in Italy, but there is an outlet that I do visit even more often. If you want to call it that way, it's my go-to outlet. And it's Ingolstadt Village, close to Munich in Bavaria in Germany. For me, it's a car ride of about 1.5 hours, 2 hours if the traffic is not good. So it's not super close, but it's the closest I can get to an outlet. And what's super interesting, at least to me, I've already watched so many Bistel Village outlet vlogs. And just a few days ago, I found out that the Ingolstadt Village belongs to the Bistel Village company, if you want to say it that way. So you kinda can expect the same concept there. Gwenny from Styled by Gwenny let me know, and I think that's a great little fun fact if you ever visit Germany and you want to get the Bistel Village outlet experience, you could try it with Ingolstadt. The footage I'm going to show you is already about a month old, because doing the voiceover for all these shops, it always takes me quite some time. And of course, it's just a sneak peek of some of the stores they have at Ingolstadt Village. They have to offer a lot more than I could show you in these 15-20 minutes. And I'm sure I could keep you updated every now and then if it is something you do enjoy to watch. This time I showed you around at Loewe, Burberry, Versace, Gucci and some more. Have fun.
We started off our outlet experience at the Loewe shop, and they had a great additional promotion of 20% off on many bags. This red one was around $1,500 instead of $2,500, and that was even before the 20% additional discount. They had the iconic Bunny crossbody purse as well in Shearling, which was around $860, but it was not part of the promotion. Loewe has amazing quality and understated designs, so if you're searching for that, you could find your bag here. This black one had an outlet price of around $1,340, but would have been part of the 20% promotion on top. At Karl Lagerfeld, only the key and bag charms were interesting to me, and they were around $60 to $75. That's about 50 to 65 euro. That deal really didn't get me. At Burberry, I had a quick look at the accessories and the bags, if there would be something that hooked me. This canvas backpack was at around $490 instead of around $800. I liked the size and the look, but I don't wear backpacks that often, so I didn't get it. As you might know, I'm always on the hunt for the perfect beige Burberry trench coat. This one was around $740 instead of $1,130. I like the fit, but the price was not killing it for me. Talking about prices that are killing it, I had such a hard time to leave this cute little Jimmy Choo crossbody bag behind. It would have been $890 regularly, and the outlet price was about $265, and it was part of an additional promotion of 10% off. The best deals this time were at Roberto Cavalli. I know it's not the most popular brand, but this pink bag has been around $260 instead of $1,440. But I didn't like the strap length. Cavalli had some amazing deals on clothing as well. This jacket was around 400 $750 instead of nearly $3,000. But as you see, way too small for me. I love the color on this pant for around $115 instead of $760, but they were really long, even too long for me. This berry colored blazer was such a bargain, $270 instead of $1,800. But I still didn't get it because I didn't need it. Same price, same problem, I didn't need it. So this checked blazer that even came with a belt did stay at the store as well. And to finish off the Cavalli experience, this red pouch clutch was only $130 instead of around $860. Coach had the Basquiat collection when we visited the outlet. I know many people on YouTube went crazy for that collection, but it's not too much of my aesthetic. I took a look at some of the pieces, but nothing hooked me to buy anything. Unfortunately, I didn't even check the price on this bag because looking back, I would have been curious. This bag charm or key charm was €49, which is around $56. But it already looked kind of dirty and used in store. Prada had quite some nylon bags to look at, but I have to admit, I've been too lazy. I just took a look at the very extraordinary all winter bags they had to offer, which featured quite a lot of fluffy fur. And to give you a price point for reference, this one would have been regularly around $4,230, and the outlet price has been around $2,500. Armani is another brand that doesn't get too much recognition right now, but I always check because you can find some great deals there. These fluffy, kinda ugly sneakers caught my eye. They would have been around $480 regularly, and the outlet price was around $290. They had quite some plain sneakers as well, and these sparkly ones were around $140 instead of $220. The problem with Armani for me is that they have kind of so many diffusion brands that from the first look, oftentimes I do not even remember which are the high-end designer pieces and which aren't. This bag would come at a regular retail price of $330, and the outlet price was only $200, which I think is great for a full leather bag, but it made me feel like it's a cheap Armani line, the Emporio Armani. As well, from the diffusion line Emporio Armani was this very extraordinary little see-through hardcover bag with leather details that would have costed regularly around $400 and was $250 at the outlet. I really liked something about these leather gloves, and they were around $110, but too small for me. Our next stop was Versace, and I have to admit that I'm not the biggest fan. I know many people are crazy for the brand, but usually it's a little bit too much for my personal taste. But of course, I checked some of the shoes anyways, and these black pumps were around $400 instead of $800. This pair of way more casual sneakers would have been $350 instead around $570. And if you want to go all that Versace loud with pink patent leather and a golden sparkly safety pin, these would have been around $430 instead of $860. And I quickly checked the summer sandals as well because I hoped for an out of season bargain, but they were still around $340. A piece that really spoke to me was this huge neutral rose shopper with the golden Medusa studs. It was half the retail price off and around $570. Here is a little overview for you what else they had in stock, especially when it comes to the bags. You can spot the shopper that I just showed you. It was available in black as well, and both do come with a pouch. Since most probably clutches will be a thing again in 2022, we can take a closer look at these. This amazingly embroidered one was half the retail price and costed around $1,150. The plain black one had an additional discount and then came to around $690. And excuse me, why didn't I take a closer look and consider it? It was €1,000 less. Now brace yourself yourself for a real bargain. This belt bag was on sale and came only to $160. But since it is only coated canvas, the retail price to begin with hasn't been too high. That would have been around $630. And because the colors were too loud for my preferences, I didn't buy it. Wait, what? And there was a bargain I didn't even realize. I had an eye on this bag at the Serravalle outlet, and there it costed €600. Now it was final sale for €246, which would be around $280 for a Versace beach bag shopper. I always check the Axe store as well. I know they are not as trendy as they have been in the past. But how beautiful are these fluffy pastel slides? They would have been around $70 in different colors. And had an additional discount of 20% on top, so $55 to be more precisely. And this leopard pair would have been around $100 with the additional discount, and this blue pair around $90. This jeans jacket is not the most innovative idea, but I think it works perfect for the brand UGG. And instead of $525, it was around $210. Please let me know if you are interested to hear some more about MCM, because it is a German brand. This little bag key charm was still around $250, which was too much for me. Same with the lion, which was around $240. These vintage vibe cassette charms were on sale for €90. That's about $100 in black or pink. And they totally could work as a little card holder as well. The same price was for this weird, I don't know, is it a bear or a dog? I didn't like that charm, but same price. Here is just a quick overview on some of the other bags they had at MCM. They had an additional discount promotion as well with 20% off of some bags, mainly bright colored ones in pink and blues. I had my eye on a pink mini bag that could be worn crossbody or as a belt bag. With the additional discount, it would have come to €310, which is around $350. This very untypical clutch in the shape of a lunch bag had the typical MCM monogram, and it was around $250. I took a quick look at Hugo Boss. This bag would have been perfect for work, but it was still around $550. I really liked this lock on it. So I took a look at the sales section, and there were really some good deals. This animal printed one would have been around $170 instead of $515, and this cute little bucket bag came at around $190. Ingolstadt Village does have a Chloé store as well, but it's quite small, so I didn't feel comfortable to film in there. Can you already guess from the shoes which store was next? Exactly, Gucci. And I always look at these shoes. They were around $330. To be honest, I did not totally get the sign full price models available on iPad. Why should I go to the outlet if I want to pay full price? These cat sneakers were €555, which is $630. And the Ace version was somewhat cheaper with €355, and that's about $400. What's kinda annoying at the Ingolstadt Gucci store, they never show which sizes are still available, and the staff is always super busy, so you have to wait quite a while. These slippers were around $340. I personally thought this hat was super ugly, but I'm quite sure it's a collector's boutique piece, and it was only $180 instead of $750. This plain wool winter hat was around $140. And my absolute insider tip, check the Gucci outlet for shawls and scarves, because you can find great deals there. I have bought Gucci scarves for €120 before, but this pink one was €200, so around $230. Same for the light blue grayish one I'm looking at right now. Maybe they have increased the prices. But the scarves are for sure worth a closer look, and if you keep searching, you could find a bargain one day. I really like the look of this pastelli mini bag, but it was still over $1,000 and so too expensive for my taste. With €625 or $715, the price point on this one was better, and this little red cutie was €720, that's about $820. And these Gucci wallet on chains that could be used as evening bags were €500 each, that's about $570. We finished our Gucci store experience with these sparkly socks that were around $200 instead of $500, but they were only under the knee stockings, not even tights.
We're back in my living room. I don't have a haul to share with you since I didn't buy anything this time. There's the trying to be mindful part of me. Let me know if you think I should have bought any of these pieces, maybe at Roberto Cavalli, because they had great deals. And I would highly appreciate it if you let me know in the comments what you like about outlet vlogs and what you don't like so much. Are you interested in the prices? Or do you just want to know the selection they offer at the outlet? Do you want to know the regular retail prices as well to have a direct comparison? Or is that a thing you would research your own if you were interested and you just want to know the outlet price? To me, it sometimes feels like I'm throwing around with numbers a lot because that's something I'm interested in. But if you don't mind for the details, I could skip some of that work the next time with calculating euro and dollar and mentioning all of these numbers. I want to improve for you, so make sure to let me know in the comments what you want to see and what you enjoy to see and what not so much. Thank you so much for watching. Hope to see you next time and bye! Visit the Foxlet out. And I told you, and. Sometimes talking is not that easy. Beester Village. Beester? Beister? As I have mentioned, here are the two videos, the Serravalle Outlet Center in Italy and the Foxtown Factory Stores in Switzerland that you could watch next.